A judgment debt of $120 million looms following a possible termination of the existing single window system contracts for clearance of goods at the country's ports. Custom Division of the Ghana Revenue Authority has begun piloting the new custom Unipass system in Takoradi despite fierce resistance from the old operators GCNet and Westblue consultant. Josephine NJJ has more in the following report.
In March 2018, the Customs Unipass single window system came into force with a South Korean company partner, Ghana Link, on board as a third vendor. This stirred controversy because the system was already being operated by two private organizations, GCNet and Westblue Consulting. GCNet has worked for 25 years till Westblue's consulting came in 5 years ago. A University of Ghana research revealed GCNet and Westblue enabled customs to increase GRA's revenue to 2.492 billion cedis in 2010. In 2017, domestic side revenue for GCNet on its system enabled revenue to increase from 3 billion in 2012 to 15.7 billion in 2017. The controversy is that GCNet has a contract to 2023, whilst Westblue has 5 more years. However, a letter cited by TV3 indicates government's readiness to pay compensation and an estimated an amount of $120 million and terminate the contract. Legal battles are imminent, with Westblue suing Unipass for allegedly plagiarizing its software for its single window project. And this has angered players who say Unipass service cannot guarantee superior quality and is expensive. Unipass charge 0.7% on free onboard value, while outgoing system was 0.68% compared to GCNet cost of 0.4% and Westblue of 0.28%.
They could have done so by approaching these two agencies to say, look, we've had enough of these two systems working. Can you, synergize, so that we can have a seamless processes? And I don't think these two companies would have resisted or objected to that, that decision or proposal coming from government. Because as far as I'm concerned, there hasn't been any gap analysis done on this system to suggest that there's actually some revenue leakages.
Policy think tank Imani Africa, in a letter to government, asks for a re-look at the decision. The termination of the contract with GCNet comes with a huge cost.
Ghana is paying more, which is more than the outgoing system which was being implemented by GCNet and Westblue. It is costing the country $4 million just for the software.
The Deputy Commissioner of Customs in charge of policy and programs, Felix Tay Mantekujo, is in favor of the new system.
See, in the business processes that we have, like we said, providing an end-to-end service is the best that we can have. Looking at the fact that the old system, you have to be moving from one system to another system. And at times, transmission problems come to the fore, where for one system, you need to, transmit data to the other system, and there are some difficulties. This one, all the players find themselves in one setting, electronic setting, where they transmit messages without any difficulties.
The Customs Division of GRA says a test run has been conducted on the Aflao border and some 1,400 officers have already been trained. Experts say the new system can only be supported if it can plug out revenue leakages. Josephine NJJ, TV3, Accra.